Isn't my hair just dicked? Today's gonna be fun. Well, first of all, I've been getting pretty bored with the games I have so far, so I bought Skyrim. I thought I'd give it a try. And also later today, we get to go fix a Dodge Caravan. Don't really care for those too much, but I already fixed one a few weeks ago. Fixed this power sliding door problem. And now we get to fix another electrical problem. So this will be fun. And it's my shift coordinator's van too, so we'll see if he'll let us record it. God, cold. It's almost April and it's still about 34 degrees or colder. All right, the stereo people aren't open until about 10 o'clock and I've got freaking 2 hours. So I'm gonna head up to AutoZone and snag some stuff for this thing. Come back later. Might head up some other places, see what time they open. I want to get a set of new speakers for this thing. Holy shit. Okay, so none of the radio shops are open right now, so I get to wait. But in the meantime, I bought a little upgrade here. Now, a long time ago, I changed the spark plug wires on this, and I just put the cheapest ones I could get, which were Duralast ones or whatever. So I figured I'd upgrade here to some premium ones. And it's been at least three years or so since I've done it, so probably wouldn't hurt to change these shitty replacements out. So I'll put some nice Bosch ones in. Smell interesting. And I haven't bothered to get new plugs yet. I'm gonna wait. I gotta order some Motorcraft Platinum ones because they're specific to the motor in this one. I can't get like Bosch Platinum ones because the threads are too fucking long because they're for the single overhead cam version. And fuck, it's just fuck. So, anyways, let's try these out. Now, when you get these cars factory, they like to take all the wires and they hide them under all these emissions controls and stuff. So what I did is when I pulled the old ones out, I just cut the wires and pulled them all the way through, and I made it so much easier and just rerouted them the way I wanted them. So this is the fun part. It's getting these off, and we do them one by one. And sometimes it helps to do this when the engine's nice and hot, because then the rubber's nice and expanded and will come off easier. Which it has for me right here. So, pull this one out. As you can see, this one's nice and dirty. It's been off-roaded a few times. I was gonna buy some Excel spark plug wires, but unfortunately you have to put the ends together, and we've already dealt with that on Adam's old Chevy van, so we're not gonna deal with it again. And then what I do with these, I just run them behind the engine. Behind this one box here. And then past the EGR tubes. Be careful of the hot exhaust manifold. There we go. You should feel it click. And once it does, it's in. Probably should put my e-brake on. Oh yeah, and these clip in so much easier. Well. Also, if you haven't replaced your ignition coil, which is this guy down here, probably wouldn't be a bad idea to do that right now. Now I'll take this guy off, which I have marked as number 4, which is wrong, but... And this goes to... this third cylinder back here. And it is freezing cold out, and it's nice that this engine's warm because it makes this job so much nicer. I'm gonna go put my e-brake on. I'm tired of it moving back and forth. Fish this guy and behind the by the heater hose or the AC hose, excuse me. I just put him in here where they're not touching anything super hot or whatever. And so that it'll make it easier next time I have to change these out. Hook this guy into the spark plug retainer thing. There we go. I'll pull off this last guy here, which is a pretty long one. It's a fun job, especially when you're dealing with the factory setup. The GR tube's cooled off quite a bit, so that's good. It's that exhaust manifold, it's fucking hot. This is the tricky one. Getting your hand down in there and pulling that son of a bitch out without burning yourself. There we go, got a good grip on it with the middle of my hand. Be careful of all your emissions tubing. Alright, so that one's out. This is one of the super long ones. So I can just take a guess. And that is the right one. Oh, click, click. Feed this one back in. Now in. So we just done the right side of the motor, or left side, or whatever side you prefer. I'm gonna go ahead and do the left side. The left side is a bitch. So I'm gonna go ahead and show it. Alright, that was actually a lot easier. When you're all done, your hands should look like this. And this is actually a pretty hot motor too. Just got done driving. So look at that. Brand new ignition coil, brand new spark plug wires, and soon we'll have platinum plugs in here, which will actually improve power and, well, for one, fuel economy. Alright, now's the fun part. Go ahead and start it. Runs amazing. gas pedal. And now I'll take her for a good old test drive. Oh yeah, it likes that. That's a lot better. Well, just spent a couple $100 and bought some nice new speakers. We got some Alpines here. Two-way 5x7s. Look at the magnet on that. Oh yeah, you got enough for all four doors.
What a nice finish! Crew,
nice work with
me so that we might set the seven.
Got more tone, so we'll have more bass. Set this down here. These are the speakers I have now. These are $5 Ford replacement two-way speakers that I bought at PartsExpress.com. They're pretty good speakers, you know, for what I paid for. I mean, they've sounded great for many years, but I felt it was maybe time to make some upgrades. Now these, I think, will make shop speakers. Now, as you can see, I have these kind of rednecked on here. So just, this has worked for four to five years now. Doesn't really matter which way you put these on. In terms of the logos. Alright, they're all installed. Here we go. Wow, what a difference. There's actually a lot more bass now. Well, we got more woofer now, so. I just need to upgrade my head unit. I'm actually gonna go to a dedicated amp for these speakers because if I put this sucker to 31, it cuts off. So, they're definitely sucking a lot of juice. They're meant to take 75 watts RMS and 250 peak. And this radio only does about 55 watts or 45 watts a channel, so it's pretty limited. So yeah, we'll get an amp and wire up to these speakers. That'll be our best bet. So yeah, I got new speakers now. It's awesome.